Welcome to Create Together. My name is Marie, and I'm an educator at Crystal Bridges Museum of American Art. For today's project, we're going to explore how food can bring us together. We'll start off by looking at a work in the permanent collection and use this to inspire our own art making at home, creating collaged portraits on a recipe box. So gather around and get ready to start your own collaborative studio. This work by Will Barnett is titled Family and Pink Table, Mary and Sons. Here, the artist depicts a family gathered together. One of the sons holds a cat, another a baseball and glove, and the smallest son hides under the table, peeking out from under Mary's skirt. Why do you think Barnett included these details in his work? What clues do they give us about the people pictured? These family members are not depicted realistically. Instead, their appearance is stylized, with Barnett emphasizing color, pattern, and shapes. The family in this painting is gathered around a table. What do you think they are going to eat? What kind of food do you make or eat with your loved ones?
You can pause this video or scroll back to any step if you need to.
Find these materials in your kit: decorative paper, small felt sheets, a wooden box, index cards, tacky glue, and colored pencils. Find this last material at home, a pair of scissors. Let's get started. Talk with your group about a time when you were together with friends or family. Who was there? List the names of a few people who are important to you. For each person on your list, decide on a few of their most noticeable features. Do they have curly hair or a favorite shirt? Make a quick sketch of that person using the colored pencils. In our drawings, we gave Kim a red beret, Nathan a baseball hat, Richard a flannel shirt, and drew me in a cozy sweater. Take out your recipe box and decide which sides you would like to decorate. Then choose where you would like to put a portrait of each person. Have each member of your group choose which portrait they would like to make. Before creating the portraits, decide how you would like to decorate the background of the recipe box. You can add designs with colored pencils or glue down paper shapes. Then cut out designs for your collage portraits using decorative paper and felt. Don't worry too much about making things look realistic. Instead, choose colors and shapes that are most exciting to you. We try to include lots of contrasting colors to make our portraits look bright and eye-catching. We also included people's favorite colors in their portraits, like giving people green hair or a pink shirt. Lay out your shapes on the recipe box to create your figure. Make sure your portrait can fit on one side of the box. If it's too big, use scissors to trim the figure or choose to focus on a smaller part of the portrait. Use tacky glue to place your shapes on the box. Hold down each of the glued materials for at least 5 seconds to make sure your portrait doesn't move. Repeat until your portraits are finished. Leave your recipe box open as it dries. Then fill the box with recipes. Use the index cards to write down meals or snacks you like. Add notes to remember who created the recipe, or mention if it's someone's favorite meal. You can also illustrate the back of the card with colored pencils. Now we've finished our recipe box. Take photos of your finished project and post it on social media using the hashtag CreateTogetherKit. If you want to further explore this project, try creating more collaged portraits with your leftover materials. Have fun exploring, and thanks so much for making art with me. If you want to explore another work in the collection, take a look at Romare Bearden's The Family. How does the color and style of this artwork compare to Family and Pink Table? What is the mood of this work? How does this scene look compared to your dinner with loved ones? Talk about these questions with your group and feel free to add more recipes to your box.